and what it will do. Then a new data is comes. Okay? So let you have 100 data in hand. Then now it is a 2-class classification problem. Now a new data comes. So it is a K nearest neighbor. You have to fix what is your K. That is which the parameters which you have to fix it before starting the algorithm, they are called the hyper parameters. Okay? There are two types of parameters. In the hyper frame, this W0, W1, that coefficient, the algorithm has to find out from the data. Right? Something which we have to provide for the algorithm to work, that is called the hyper parameters. Something for the algorithm has to learn from the data, that is the parameter. So here, take the user has to give to the algorithm. Okay? So we say that K is equal to 3. That is, we are giving to the algorithm K is equal to 3. Now what happens is, when new data comes, till then it has not done any job. Okay? When new data comes, it will find the 3 immediate neighbors of the new data. You understand what is that? When a new data comes, from the given data, the algorithm has to find the 3 immediate neighbors of the new data. What does that mean?
Majority.
problem. Okay? So what is the majority saying? We will assign the given data point to that class. Right? What is the majority saying? So how is it working now? How does it work? When a new data point comes, it has to find the k immediate neighbors of the given data point. Then you can decide the class of the given data point by what the majority of the data points are seen. You can assign that either to the positive class or to the negative class, depending upon what is the majority saying. Okay, so this is a very simple algorithm to start with, right? If it is a regression, what we do is we will take the average of all the neighbors by value. We will take the average of all the neighbors by value. Okay? If it is a regression, what will you do? We will take the average of the neighbors by value. K immediate neighbors. Okay, so we have seen a very simple algorithm, right? It is a basic learning k nearest neighbor. Here k is that k, what it is called, the k stands for what? It is a hyper parameter. Okay? That is the user has to say whether you need 3, 5, 7. That also you have to fix it, okay? But the best time you have to find it. That now you see. So okay, perfect. That is not the algorithm's job. We have to say find it. You will find the 7 immediate neighbors and you will go for majority voting. What are the immediate neighbors, majority, what is it saying for classification? So regression, what will you do? You will take the call the output of the immediate neighbors and it will take the average. Okay, that will be the y values of the new point. Now let's see some performance measure, right? So in classification regression, so after exam after teaching, there are some evaluation tools to check how much the student has grasped the subject, as the student has become self-sufficient in that subject, right? We have to put some evaluation tools, some cases examination. Some cases that won't do, we will put some seminar test examination. Some places we can buy comments. Why? There are different strategies. Why? Whatever comment strategies we will do, we can apply for everything. So, depending upon the circumstances, we will change the evaluation tools, right? In that case, after developing an algorithm, how can you say that I have done my job? Right? That is, this model is good enough. Yes, good. I can give it to the real world problem. I have done my job. So that means you have to check thoroughly whether you are doing the right thing. Or else, is it 10 years neighbor to do the algorithm for this data? Or should I have to use some other? That gives us. Then I'm going to check it. Right? Or I have chosen case equals to 3. I go for another game to survive. That's all you have to do. So for that you need some performance measures. So let's see what are the performance measures. Let's first see the case of classification. Okay? So usually what is using some big data will be given to you, which we call it as training data. And some data which we call it as testing data. Okay? So first one is accuracy. Accuracy means what is that? Correctly classified. That is by using a KNN, and if the algorithm has correctly set the thousands of 8 data points, what is the accuracy for? What is the accuracy? 8 by 10, right? 10 is the total number of testing points and 8 is the correctly classified points. This is the training data, and let this x1, t1, x2, t2 we know its corresponding output, but we will ask the algorithm to generate the output of that, and we will check it whether that is correct or right. And if it has, for that example, out of 10, if it has correctly set the thousands of 8 points, we say that 8 by 10. But I have written a formula like this. TP plus TN. What is TP? It stands for true positive. True positive means that, what is the meaning of that? The, actually, the data belongs to the positive class, and the algorithm also says it belongs to the positive class. That is true positive plus true negative. And what is the denominator? What is false positive mean? It is that, what is false? It is falsely saying that it belongs to the positive class. So that means actually the data belongs to negative class. Okay, falsely saying that it is, its prediction is wrong, and falsely saying that it belongs to the positive class. That is, it is false positive plus false negative means it is falsely saying that it is negative class. Alright? So actually it is positive class. So that is accuracy. Okay? That is overall performance. Or in other words, total number of correctly classified points divided by total number of testing points. We have written this on the form. Now, I have written some more measures. Why we need other measures? Okay. Well, let's see why we need other measures. I have 100 testing points in my hand. Testing points. Out of which 90 belongs to the negative class. Out of which 90 belongs to the negative class. And 10 belongs to the positive class. That is the data, right? 100 testing points, out of which 90 belongs to the positive class and 10 belongs to the negative class. And I have read KNN, I have some training data in hand, and I have tested the performance of this 100 data point, and I have got the accuracy as 90%. Okay? 90% I have got. Right? So, when I see the answer, maybe I am happy for at least 90%. It's not bad. Okay? But when I look into closely, what I see is that whatever data it is showing is saying negative. Whatever data it is saying, it belongs to the negative class. Okay? Whatever data it is not, it doesn't know how to. Whatever data we say is negative, 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 negative. So the data in my hand is not balanced data, it is imbalanced because the number of negative points is very much larger than the number of positive points. That is why I got the 90% accuracy, because so there are 90 negative points and it has correctly set the answers for that point, but it does not show the correct answer for at least one positive point. It has not said. It is said it has not learned anything actually. What is the data we say? It is saying negative, 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 negative. So the data in my hand is like that. It is an imbalanced data set. That is why I got the 90% accuracy. So it is good. It is not good. It has not learned anything. divided by actually total number of positive points. Total number of positive points means PP plus false negative, right? So, that is the part of the data point which doesn't hold as negative, that is also positive point. So it is PP divided by PP plus false positive, or else it is how many points the algorithm classified as positive divided by total number of positive points. So for this example, what is the answer for sensitivity? What? It is 0, right? So 90% accuracy and 0 sensitivity. That from seeing that, at first we can say that yes, this is not going in the right direction, right? So instead of just relying on accuracy, we need some more measures to look into closely what is happening inside. So that is sensitivity. Same way, the another name for sensitivity is recall. Same way, specificity. We now need to check how good it is in identifying the negative point. So it is total number of points that algorithm has classified as negative divided by total number of points in the negative part, or it is Tn plus Tn by Tn plus Sp. Now precision is actually out of the point the algorithm has classified as positive, that is Tp plus false positive, how much is correctly classified as positive. Tp plus false positive is the total number of points it has said as positive, out of which how many it is correctly said as positive. Then S measure is this and this together, precision and recall. It is the harmonic mean of precision and recall. Okay? So these are some of the common performance measures which we use for classification. Now for regression, we use something called mean square error. Mean square error, that is correct output minus the predicted output, the whole square, take that mean of all those errors, that is the mean square error. Now in the classification there is one more measure there, which is the weighted. Now that is about the performance measures. Now next is we say that this weighting data, testing data, so how we will divide the data into this weighting and testing data. How we will divide that into training data, sometimes we divide it into training, validation and testing data, or sometimes we divide it into just training data and testing data. So how we will do that? Or is the K means K, how to put K equals to 3 K, it's a user's job. So we need to, we cannot arbitrarily choose it. K equals to 3, there is some way to find that particular value. For that, we will find the algorithm with a different value, K, 3, K, 4, K, 5, and then you have to select the best one. So how we are going to divide the data into different codes, like testing data, data, validation data. So that is what we are going to do. The first one is hold out method. Okay? The hold out method, what we do is given some data will be in your hand. Your entire job you have to do that to see the data. You have to thoroughly validate the model. You have to find all the parameters, which is a hypothesis, find all the W0s and all. And you have to consume yourself, yes, whether you need to access the sensitivity and you check everything. So that you have to divide the data into testing data and training data. So how you are going to divide it? So that they are going to include. So first is the hold out method. data. First we will take the case of dividing the data into training and testing set. So given the data, we will choose 70% for, randomly choose 70% for training set and the remaining 30% for testing set. Okay, 70% for training set and 30% for testing set. But you have tested not only one, with only one data set. That is not enough. That may be biased data. In some way, some good data might have come in that bunch, some testing data. That might be the reason you are taking the good answer. So you have to test with different sets of data to make sure that you have come across it is not because of the goodness in that data that you are getting the answer. So we will run this experiment 30 times. For example, statistically something is greater than 30, we can call it as large. So in a way, we will run it as 30 times. So what it will do? Each time it will take 70% as the training set and the remaining 30% as the testing set, and by the one iteration, training set, testing set. At the end, you will find accuracy, which is the classification, accuracy, sensitivity, specificity, whatever performance measures you are using. Like that, you will run it 30 times. So at the end, how many sets of accuracy, sensitivity, specificity you will get? How many sets? 30. And you will take the average of all this. And then looking at that number, you can say that this is working fine. Right? For example, if you want to fix the hyperparameter AC, K equals to 3, K equals to 4, each time with K is equal to 3, you have to repeat 30 times, not with one training set and one testing set. That won't do, right? You have to repeat it some number of times. That will be 30 times, you have to repeat it. And you have to take the average of that, and looking at that number, you can say that your algorithm is working. It's working fine. That is hold off method. In another is, we divide the data into training set, validation set, and testing set. For that, what we do is, when we give up the data, at first we will take 20%.
Testing point, then the remaining I have 80 data in hand.
With this 80 data, I will use this whole down method, that is 70% for training data and 30% for testing data. That is 80 into 70, approximately equal to 56 data points as training and the remaining as the calibration set. And using this, only this data set, we will run the algorithm and 30 times. You are not going to touch the that 20 at all, and you will find the average performance of the algorithm. Then what will you do? You can take all the 80 data points together. If you have it yourself, you can take all the 80 points together and using that, for example, if you want to find which is the best K, so using this, you set up this 20% as the testing point, and then the remaining you will test with k equals to 3, 4, 5, and you will find that k equals to 6 is the best. Then with k equals to 6, you can take 80 points together, and then you can test its performance on the testing set which you have set apart. So that is the testing, training and validation. Otherwise, in the training and validation, you will 70 and 30, and you will run it for average 30%, average 30 times, which gives the average performance. And if you are happy with the result, you can take all the data points together, and you will say that you can develop a model, and that will be your final model. Okay, so that is how we will use code graph. The next is k-fold cross validation. Here what we do is, if you are using it for training and validation, k-fold, you divide the data into k different folds. For example, 10-fold means divide the data into 10 different folds. There will be 10 iterations will be there. Total there will be 10 iterations. And in each iteration, only one of the folds will become the testing point or validation point. That is, if there are 10 folds are there, 1, 2, 3 to 10, the first iteration, 10 fold will be the testing point. The data in the remaining 9 folds will be the training point. In the second iteration, 9th fold will come in the 9th fold will come as the validation set or testing set, and the remaining all will come as the training set. You will divide the data into 10 different folds or 8 different folds, such that they are mutually exclusive. That is, there is no common. All data is in at most one fold. Okay? For example, if there are 100 data points are there, and if you are dividing it into 10 different folds, each fold will have 10 points, and the intersection is null set. None of the folds has any common element, and each fold will come to the testing fit at most one. If in the first iteration 10 fold will come in the testing phase, then in the remaining 9 coming iterations it won't come in the testing phase. If in the first iteration 10 fold will be the testing phase, in the second iteration 9 fold, the third iteration 8 fold, 7 fold, so that all folds will come in the testing phase at most once. Okay? So in that way, we have tested the performance of the algorithm set of the testing set or validation set. So that is the k-fold cross validation. How it works? We will divide the data into k different folds. So and in each there will be how many iterations? K iterations. In this test there will be 10 iterations. And in each iteration, at most one fold will come as the testing point, and the remaining set up at 20% as your testing and you are do not touching at all. Remaining 80 you will perform the game fold. That is divided into 8 different folds, run in 30 depth, and at the end you can test it on the remaining 20%. So that is the case fold done. Fold down at the end.
Does not depend, it will be